Average daily cases and deaths from COVID-19 just spiked as hospitals around the country struggle to keep up. Britt Conway has details on what the federal government is doing in the way of treatment and prevention in the face of a desperate push for normalcy.
It's up to you, New York.
Broadway is back.
Welcome back to the theater.
After 18 months of darkness in the theater district, the show must go on. But safety is also taking center stage, with strict vaccine and mask requirements as Delta continues to spread. One in 500 Americans has died of COVID-19. The vast majority of the people dying now are unvaccinated. Most of the people in the hospital now are unvaccinated. New estimates show preventable costs for treating hospitalized unvaccinated patients reached $5.7 billion over the last 3 months. As hospitals struggle under the weight of it all, the U.S. government announced a contract with Regeneron Tuesday for 1.4 million additional doses of the company's monoclonal antibody treatment. The treatment is in such high demand, last month, another company that also makes a monoclonal antibody treatment reported a global shortage of their drug. So the push for prevention persists. More than 179 million Americans are fully vaccinated, and boosters could be next. But the FDA has to take into account dueling data on the issue when it meets on Friday, all set against the backdrop of political friction on the matter. The road to boosters is shaping up to be a bumpy one. I'm Britt Conway reporting.